In this video, we will show you the method of how to batch import Microsoft Outlook PST files directly into Exchange Server Mailbox. We bring you the solution: SysTools Exchange Import Software. Let's check out the main features of the software. The software maps and import MS Outlook PST to public folder Exchange Server Mailbox in bulk. Import PST mails, calendars, contacts, tasks, journals, and notes to Exchange Server. Also inaccessible and password protected PST files can be imported to Exchange Server Mailbox. There is also option to search and import Outlook PST files within the domain network. Now let's check out the application prerequisites before installing the software. To import data directly into a live Exchange server, the Exchange versions mentioned here are supported. Exchange mailboxes should have complete administrative rights for the Exchange versions mentioned here. If you are using Windows 10 or any of the versions mentioned, then launch the tool as run as administrator. For Exchange version 2003, make sure that the migration machine should be in same domain as Exchange server. Microsoft Outlook should be installed and should be configured properly for any valid or dummy profile or account. Now let's install and run the software. The software opens with a user-friendly interface. Here you can see multiple options to add PST files. Let's select the Add File option first. You can select this option to add single or multiple PST files. After making the desired selections, click Open button. Now you can see the chosen files will appear. If you want to remove the files, click Remove button. Then the files will be removed. The software also provides option to add PST folder containing multiple PST files. Click Add Folder button to choose a desired folder. After choosing the folder, click OK. Now click Next button to proceed. In the next window, you can see further advanced options. Here you have to enter the admin SMTP address and password in the respective field options below. Now select the desired Exchange server version from the drop-down option. Then you have to enter the server IP in the field option below. And you can check the same as above checkbox. If the Active Directory IP is as same as the server IP. And you can check the search user in subdomain option. If you want to import mailboxes of subdomain users as well. After entering the details, click Submit button. Now the software will authenticate the credentials. After successful authentication, you have to enter the desired Exchange mailbox in the field option. And click the authentication field. In similar way, you can enter the respective details for all the selected files as well. Then in the Select Categories option below, you can see multiple advanced filter options. In the Mails option, All Mails checkbox is selected by default. Select the Apply Filter option if you want to filter mails according to certain date range. Now click Set button. Then a small window appears. Select the Include Date checkbox. Then you can select the date range from the drop-down. After making the selections, click Apply button. To proceed further, you can also see the Contacts option. If you want to exclude duplicate contacts while importing, check the box option, and click Set button. A window opens with further options to choose. The following properties will be considered to check duplicate contacts. After making the selections, click Apply button. In similar way, you can apply desired filter options to calendars, tasks, journals and notes. After choosing the desired options, you can also check the Apply Advanced options and click Settings for more advanced options. Here you can choose the Maintain Folder Hierarchy option and the Map Folders option. Choose the desired folder from the drop-down option. And there is option to enter the changed folder name in the field option below. After entering the desired options, click Save and then Apply button. Now click Import button to start importing the files. Here you can see the process, and after the migration completes successfully, click OK. Then you can click the Save Report button to save the migration report in CSV format. Now let's check out the output. Open Outlook for web app on your system and enter the user credentials in the respective field options below and click Sign In. Now you can see the migrated data here. You can also see the imported contacts by selecting the contacts icon. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details and purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.